To you that you've taken over from her, that you've become the new Mrs. Sweet. I think it frightens her.
Or maybe I'm just giving you something you can't. I want you to say that this is something you can't just turn on and off.
I'm going out for a drink with Lillian tonight.
Really?
Yeah, you're okay with that, aren't you?
Me? Fine.
If we do that on Saturday, we'll win no problem.
Don't get too cocky. I was carrying you out there.
Yeah, right.
Come on, guys. Better get a move on.
Oh, my God. Annette is going to kill me. Come on.
Thanks, Mum.
Thought I'd get breakfast going, as you're obviously having a bit of a lie-in.
Three bedrooms, big garden, good price.
Yeah, looks interesting. Why don't you make an appointment?
Yes, darling. Are you putting on weight?
No. Do you think so?
Sorry.
I should think so, too.
It's my fault. I forgot to remind them.
Don't you try and take the blame for it. The two of them would be in that boat all day if they could.
Mm-hmm.
If you're this late on the day, I'm running off with the organist.
Isn't the organist a woman?
Well, I don't know why we have to rehearse anyway.
So you don't make a mess of it. And afterwards, Simon gets to ask us searching questions about the strength of our commitment.
Yes, but that'd be easy. I'm afraid you're stuck with me.
Oh.
Come on.
I just thought I'd fix this before we get busy. We want everyone to be able to see everything, don't we?
Good idea. New skirt?
Yeah. Ali-Ann got one at the weekend, so I thought, why not? You're only young once, aren't you? Good morning, sweet general practice.
Not a word, okay?
Not even if I offer to stump up for the rest of the herd?
Right, could you just hold on a moment, please?
What are you doing here?
Nice to see you, too. Came to ask you to lunch. Little thing to welcome Andrew home. Did leave a message.
Yeah, it's not a very good time, Mum. Mum!
I'm sorry.
Oh,
well, aren't you going to introduce us, finally?
Sure. Anna, this is my mum. Mum, Anna.
Anna. Well, very nice to meet you, Anna.
Do you know, I hadn't realised what the time is. I really have to go.
No, don't go on my account.
I'm not. Nice to meet you.
Just give me a minute, Mum.
I've got oncology on the phone from Queen Mary's. They want to talk to you about Mark Fletcher.
Tell them I'll call them back. I'm just...
Well, you might as well take it now, as you're here.
Right. Hello. All right, yeah. Okay.
Excuse me, this is a private notice board.
In a public place?
Yes, but it's for surgical and medical matters only.
Well, that's to do with health, isn't it?
Well, could you take it down, please?
That's unfair.
Just take it down.
Okay, okay. Don't put your knickers in a twist. Because we'll all see. Karen Gibson, if you'd like to come through.
Of course. I'll get him in. Okay, thanks.
Is everything all right?
No, not really.
To be honest, I'm surprised it's still going on.
Well, forgive me, Reverend Mother, for I have sinned.
Do you have to be so flip?
Well, do you have to be so nosy?
Just concern, that's all.
Well, you needn't be.
And if she leaves her husband, what then? If she's prepared to be reckless with his feelings, she'll do the same with yours.
She's not like that. If only you knew her better.
If only.
I'm not the one being cheated on, Mum.
Eddie, listen. In a situation like this, everyone gets cheated in the end.
Here you go.
Thanks. Actually, Muriel, have you got a minute?
Is everything all right?
Yes, it's just, and usually it's fine. It's just maybe sometimes... What you're wearing isn't quite right.
It's a skirt, isn't it? Is it because it's leather?
It's not so much the leather as the length.
Well, Bob says we've got great legs.
Well, yes, you have. And I'm sure it's a great skirt for going out in. It's... I just don't think it's the right image for a doctor's surgery.
Well, how do you mean?
I just don't think it's very appropriate for...
What? A woman of my age?
I just think maybe something a little longer would suit better, that's all. You know, I mean, we don't want blood pressure readings any higher than they need to be, do we? So maybe if you could just tone it down a bit and wear something a little more...
Suitable?
Exactly.
Whatever you say, Doctor.
I thought you should have a look at it as it hasn't healed.
It looks worse than it is. How long has it been like this? I fell doing cross country. That's about a month ago.
A month?
Yeah.
I would have expected it to heal within a week. Have you been working on it?
I have to.
What sort of classes do you do?
The lot, really. Cardio funk, boxer size, slimnastics. Hey, you should try my bums and tums class.
Thanks.
Well, Karen, you need to get this better, which means complete rest.
I can't. I've just gone self-employed.
You don't really have a choice.
If you put pressure on this, it will make it worse.
And we should run some tests, find out why the wound hasn't healed.
Why?
It's just precautionary, but we should check you for anemia, diabetes. Be on the safe side.
Just can't believe it. I thought you got through it.
Do you want me to tell him?
No. I've got to do it.
I love a thing to have to tell a mate. When's he coming in?
I thought I should go to him. Now. Just cover for me.
Sure. Listen, if you want to talk about it, I'm here.
Thanks.
Hey, big man. Finished tending to the sick and needy. Don't tell Annette I'm here. She wasn't going to go with the seating plan again. It's back, isn't it?
Yes.
I've fought it before, I'll fight it again. I'm fitter this time. I know more. I mean, we've caught it early enough, haven't we?
It's not quite that simple, Mark.
Why not?
Some of the cancer cells from the primary site have spread to the brain. You have a brain tumor, which is why you've been getting the headaches.
Right. What can they do for that? An operation, what?
It's just too deep in the cortex to be removed surgically.
There must be treatment options, though.
They can give you dexamethasone. That'll shrink it a little bit.
What about radiotherapy? I mean, I did it before, didn't I? I mean, last time the doctors were all doom and gloom, but I showed them.
Yeah, but...
Do whatever it takes, Jeff.
Mark. There's nothing they can do. I'm just sorry.
I'm getting married.
Would you like me to be there when you're telling it?
No. No. I'll tell her.
There we go.
Hello, Dad.
The Wanderer returns. Careful of the small one, it's got some breakables in it.
Oh, Dad, you remember Lillian? She was at Uncle Ed's funeral.
How could I forget?
Nice to see you again, Dr. Sweet.
Mr. Sweet, surgeon. Call me Andrew.
Your room's all ready.
Good. Thanks for asking me to stay. Gives me time to find somewhere permanent.
I've done out the back bedroom and everything.
The back bedroom? Sounds perfect.
You really watching this?
There's nothing else on.
We can make our own entertainment.
We can't, not here.
Go on.
No, it just doesn't feel right. And anyways... okay, that felt right.
Darling,
I've... Sorry, didn't think you'd be back so soon.
Clearly. See, you've had supper. Maybe you should think about getting an early night.
Do you want to have another look at those house details?
Yes, please. I feel like I'm 14 again.
Oh, get lots of sofa action at 14, did you?
Enough.
Please stay. I'd really like you to.
Don't be silly, you'll be fine.
In town, back in England. You had a pressure pump on that shower.
Right. I'll leave you boys to it.
Why don't you stick around?
I've got plans. We must have a lot to talk about. Nice to meet you, though.
Pleasure's all mine. You've done well for yourself there.
Well, don't sound so surprised.
Hope you haven't gone into too much trouble.
You've fed me well in first class.
Why is she doing this?
She's making a point. Just say you're sorry and get things back to normal.
Muriel.
Morning, Doctor.
How long are you going to keep up the grabber-granny look, then?
Oh, till he sees sense.
He can be very stubborn.
He doesn't know what stubborn means.
I once told Bob there'd be no more mattress action until he creosoted our back fence.
How long did that last?
Oh, 12 years in September.
Shouldn't you be at the hospital chasing defenceless nurses?
Don't start chasing officially for another month.
Or is it that you haven't got the stamina for it anymore?
No. It's Jeff. He cooked me a bloody fry-up this morning. It's like staying some backwater B&B.
I suppose mere gratitude is beyond you.
Why couldn't he have checked me into a hotel?
Because he wants to spend some time with you.
We can't all be like you, George.
Well, watch and learn then, Andrew dear. Don't let Jeff down. He's a fine, decent young man. Where he gets it from, I shall never know. Hello? No, this is her mother-in-law. Oh, good. Thank you. I'll tell her. Bye. Estate agent.
Nick and Deb on the move, eh?
So it would seem.
I've made an appointment with your oncologist. He'll be able to explain things a lot better than I can, but, you know, I'm always here if you need to talk things through. So how's Annette? Haven't you told her?
I don't know how.
You need her right now. You don't have to go through this alone.
I'll tell her after the wedding, when things have calmed down.
Don't you think you should tell her now? Look, I can help.
I said no, Jeff, all right? Just let things be. It's not the right time at the moment.
It's okay.
It's not okay. I'm bloody terrified. What if she won't marry me? I can't live without her.
But she loves you, doesn't she?
Yes. Me. Not some bloke that'll be pushing up daisies in a year.
I should skulk on the porch like the social leper I am. What's up with you?
You don't want to know.
Try me.
Just leave it, Dad, okay?
Where's Lillian tonight, anyway? We could all go out for a bite.
No, I've got an early start with a regatta tomorrow. Are you coming?
Of course. Want to see you and your new hobby.
I've been rowing for about 7 years, Dad.
Of course you have. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Thank you. Put it there, would you, darling? You remember it used to be in Eddie's room? I wondered if you'd tune it in for me.
Well, it should come with an aerial. Was there not one with it?
I didn't see one, no.
Why do you want it in here?
Wants to give you and Nick a bit of space.
We have plenty of space.
Well, privacy then.
Georgina, if this is about the other night.
Deborah, darling, I'm just doing my bit to ensure we all get along as best we can. I'm sure it must be a bit of a chore living with the mother-in-law sometimes.
She knows.
You're being paranoid.
Georgina and a portable TV.
How could she know?
She's good. She has a sixth sense about these things.
Thanks so much for doing this. I couldn't manage on my own.
That's okay, Mum. Mum, I wanted to talk to you.
Oh, yeah?
About me and Deb living here.
Darling, I know what you're going to say. You want your own space. Look, I understand it'll take more than a portable television to achieve that. I've been having a few thoughts, actually. We don't always have to eat together. We can do our own thing. Although, I'm sure you appreciate having a meal on the table at the end of a hard day.
Yeah.
You've got a lot on running that surgery at the moment. I came by yesterday to see Muriel looking like Whistler's mother. What's going on there?
Yeah, bit of a communication problem. Hmm.
Well, let's make sure we don't have the same thing here, hmm? You come first, you know that, Nick.
And you, of course, Deb.
She knows.
Jeff's lovely. Do you reckon he's the one?
Oh, we've not been going out long. We're just having a laugh. You know, it's nothing serious.
I'm not sure he sees it that way.
Yes, he does.
Oh, come on, I've seen the way he looks at you. He's serious. I envy you. It's always exciting at the beginning. Mark and I have just been old married couples soon.
Come on, Jeff! Come on! Finishes. Come on. Finishes. Finishes.
Nice going, mate. Nice going.
What the hell is the matter with you?
Me? You wouldn't want to act another bionic man.
No, no, no. I told you to speed up.
Don't be stupid. You broke the rhythm. I couldn't keep up with you. What are you trying to prove?
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
No, no, no. Come on, say it. I'm sick. Well, I don't feel it. I feel fantastic. And you're pissing all over it. It's my life.
It's her life too. For God's sake, tell her.
Well, what if she leaves me?
She's not gonna leave you. She loves you.
What do you know about women?
Sorry?
Come on. How many times have you come into the clubhouse with some girl saying she's the one? You live in this world of bloody arts and flowers! You get carried away! You scare them off! It's happening now with Lillian! I give it to the end of the month!
This has nothing to do with me and Lillian. This is to do with you and Annette. Now, you know you've got to tell her. You're just too bloody pig-headed and stupid to do it!
Just sort your own life out first before you start interfering with mine. All right?
It's always next, Jim. Come on, Lillian's getting the drinks in. There's Mark. He's not sulking, is he?
Annette. There's something I have to tell you.
And please, tell me I did the right thing. Shit, shit, shit.
Hey, hey. What do I know? God. It just makes you realise how lucky you are, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it does. I really like you, you know, Lillian.
I really like you, Jeff.
How many are coming?
Just the family. But you know what big appetites boys have.
You spoil them rotten.
Man cannot live by pizza alone.
Well, now that we're looking for a place of our own, Nick's just going to have to get used to it.
Now, where's Jeff gone to and Eddie?
Yes, it's Zoe.
At least that gives you time to change.
Change?
You're enough to be your granddaughter.
Oh, I see. Pedal pushers. Well, it is summer, I suppose. Jeff, finally.
I thought it'd be okay to bring Lillian.
How are we? Fine, you? Thriving. Now, Jeff, why don't you take Lillian over to see Nick? Find her a nice piece of salmon. Sure you don't want to change?
Where have you two been?
The race?
The race, sorry, completely went out of my head. Did you win?
No.
Oh, good. Didn't miss anything, then.
For God's sake.
Thank you. So you're here to stay?
Certainly am. Suppose I should start looking for a place soon. Despite enjoying staying with my boy here.
Or maybe I could search out some properties for you.
Are you still working even today, Lillian?
It would be a pleasure.
Bad time to buy at the moment, though, isn't it? Property market round here has simply rocketed.
I don't know. I'd say bricks and mortar are always a good investment.
Yeah.
Any more, anyone?
No.
I think Jeff could do with a pound of flesh, preferably mine.
Why, what have you done now?
Been remiss, as usual.
Look, this has nothing to do with the bloody race, okay?
Poor boy. Too sensitive for his own good.
Not something anyone could accuse you of, is it?
Where are we going?
It's a secret.
I'm not going any further until you tell me.
Is that so?
Did it. Me back, my... Eddie, put me down!
No.
Eddie, put me down!
No.
Eddie, stop! Eddie, put me down! Eddie, put me down!
Eddie, about time. You got to introduce us?
Yeah. Everyone, this is Anna. Anna, my family.
Eddie.
Very nice to see you again. Can I get you something to drink?
No, I'm not staying.
Anna.
What are you doing?
I should have told you, I'm sorry, but I knew that if I did, you wouldn't have come. I've messed up, but please, now that you're here, please stay for me.
It's just a game to you, isn't it? This whole thing?
Of course it's not. I wanted you to meet my family. Is that so unusual? You're important to me. I want you to leave your husband.
Oh, no, you don't, Eddie. Don't start something you can't
What's
finish.
What's that supposed to mean?
Look, let's just quit while we're ahead, shall we?
What?
It's over.
Do you think about me when you're making love to him?
No, I think about him when I'm making love to you. I never want to see you again.
The estate agent said that if we offered the asking price today, we'd be accepted.
In need of modernization? It's a joke. It's a money pit.
Okay, so it needs a bit of work.
Oh, come off it.
But we can stay at your mum's while we do it up. You know, evenings, weekends.
Yeah, like we haven't got enough on our plate already.
Could you please show some enthusiasm?
I am. I just don't think that this is the place.
I doubt if there'll ever be anything good enough.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. Is that other place we're seeing this evening? What time's that appointment?
Don't worry, we'll be back in time for dinner. We're having shepherd's pie. It's your favourite, apparently. Here you go.
Oh, thanks.
Here's your post.
Thanks. Muriel, you've made your point now. Why don't you just get back into your own clothes?
Maybe this is what I should be wearing, though.
What?
Well, I'm not 18 anymore, am I?
That's just the cardigan talking.
If only. 1 minute I'm lying flat on my back, with my sister pulling up the flies on my jeans with a fork. The next it's all crow's feet and batwing arms. Got old. Didn't realise it.
You're not old.
I like short skirts. I like lycra tops. I just didn't realise how other people saw me. Sad. Middle-aged woman.
Nobody thinks that.
If they did, they wouldn't be wrong, though, would they?
Good boy.
Good boy.
All right. They said I'd find you down here.
Got to get Dodgem spruced up.
Dodgem?
Yes, some fellas from the fairground took their rides but left their dog. It's found wandering across the dual carriageway, poor thing. If someone doesn't take him this week, he gets... Anyway, he needs to look his best. We have to get on. Come, boy.
Annette?
What?
I'm sorry for springing it on you like that yesterday. You OK?
Why did you have to ruin everything? Couldn't you have waited till after the wedding to tell him?
I couldn't keep it from you.
You couldn't let him have one perfect day. God knows he hasn't got many to look forward to, has he?
I'm his doctor. He's going to need you.
Apparently not. The wedding's off. He can't see the point. I suppose he's right. Now, the happiest day of our lives, it'd just be like one sick joke.
I'm so sorry.
It's a bit late for that now.
I'll talk to Mark.
No, just leave it, Jeff. Okay? I need to give Dodgem his run. Come on, boy. Come on.
I hope that tracksuit doesn't mean you've been on a 10-mile run.
I had a class this morning. I couldn't let them down.
I said complete rest.
I need the money. Anyway, it's not my nature to rest. I'm a get-up-and-go kind of person.
Not for much longer if these test results are anything to go by. How well are you eating, Karen?
Really healthily.
A well-balanced diet?
Yes.
Do you get enough protein?
Well, yeah.
Your test results show that you have a very low serum potassium level.
Well, that's fine. I'll just eat more bananas.
Your liver function tests are abnormal. You're low on glucose and anemic. Do I need to go on? You have to increase your protein intake.
Right. So if I eat, I'll get fat again. Check my notes. I was pushing 16 stone when I was a teenager.
Yes, but at 7'8", your health is probably more at risk than before.
What, from a cut foot?
No, this isn't just about the foot. If you don't change your diet, you risk osteoporosis, potential infertility, you could even die from heart problems.
Now you're just trying to scare me?
Yes, and I hope it's working. This is very serious.
But if I eat, I'll get fat again.
Karen, carry on like this and I will have to admit you to hospital. Is that what you want?
Did you need to make another appointment?
You've taken my poster down.
I've told you, surgery matters only.
And that's all that matters to you people, isn't it? I mean, you don't care about real life. I need to make money. I had 6 people in my class last week. Doesn't even pay for the room hire.
I'm sorry, but we've got a policy here.
How can I take time off work? How am I supposed to live? This is all I'm trained for. What am I gonna do? I'm sorry.
What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Sorry I interfered.
She needed to know.
She loves you.
That's what I like about you, Jeff. Everything's so simple. She wants a home and she wants a family. She's 26 years old. I can't promise her any of that.
So what are you going to do now? Just sit around and wait to die?
Look, just help me out here, Jeff. I'm trying to do the right thing by you.
What, by breaking her heart?
Better now than later.
That's the way she wants it?
I thought I was doing everything right. I got thin, I got fit, and I loved it that everyone told me how good I looked.
It's not about what other people think.
Isn't it?
You know where I turn when I get down? We've got chalky digestives, bourbons, custard creams.
Do you know how many calories are in just one of these things?
Yes, I do. But I also know they don't kill you. Although there's a Garibaldi down at the bottom you might want to steer clear of. We can't all look like Cindy Crawford every day. Sometimes I wake up, I look more like Michael Crawford.
I'm sorry about what I said to you. The other day about your skirt. You look great. Much better than in those frumpy clothes.
Well, it's easy to criticise. Much harder to rise above it. I'll make you that appointment, shall I?
I've been thinking, and
day, doctors.
And can I just say how well you're looking today?
Well, this. Just threw on the first thing that came to hand.
You look very nice.
Suitable enough?
Yes. Yes, very. And also, very you, which is a good thing because we miss the old you around here.
Go on, say it.
Say what? I told you so.
You're pleased, aren't you?
That it's over, yeah. She wasn't right for you.
Oh, and how do you know that, Mum?
Because I know you, Eddie. You've always wanted what you can't have.
Why do you always have to stick your nose in? You reckon you could do a better job of running my life than I can?
I care about you.
No, Mum. You care about yourself. Always have.
That's not fair, Eddie. Nobody could love you more than I do.
Which is why it sometimes seems like you're my bloody wife.
Georgina, can I have a word?
Thank you.
Maybe I spoke out of turn. If Ed were here, he'd say it was typical Eddie. Hot-headed and irresponsible. But I had to say something.
It is Eddie's life.
When they're young, you tell them to keep away from the water's edge. That instinct doesn't stop.
Maybe sometimes you have to let them fall in. Could be the only way they'll learn to swim.
Or drown.
Well, yes.
I know you think I'm some silly old fool who can't let go. But this house, the boys, Ed, they've been my life for so long. Take them away. I'm not sure what I'm left with.
You don't like this one.
Well, maybe I hadn't fully realized its potential. What do you reckon?
It looks smaller than I remember.
But I've put in an offer now.
Really?
Huh?
Well, without discussing it with me first.
Well, I thought you'd be pleased.
Well, I am, but there's no rush, is there? I mean, we're all right for the moment.
What, we don't want to move now?
No, let's just leave it for a bit.
Okay.
What about the offer? Are they accepted?
What offer? You're my wife, and I love you, and you'll always come first, okay?
We should get back. Casserole tonight.
I don't really feel like it. I don't know about you, but I feel like going to the pub and getting hammered.
Yeah, you're on. But we are going to move out sometime, aren't we? Promise?
Promise.
Just give your mum a call. Let her know that we'll be late.
Do you want a hand with that?
I can manage.
What do you have to do at this wedding?
Just show people to their seats.
Nothing too complicated then.
No. Even I can't mess that up.
Here, let me.
I can do it. Thanks for the cigars. There's no need.
I'm not blind to my own faults, Jeff. I can't make up for all the things I've missed. Maybe I wanted a mate, not a son.
We are mates, Dad. Besides, I'm a grown-up. Can't keep blaming you for everything.
There.
Hang on.
I thought you said you were going to keep that thing outside.
Hey, you're all right, aren't you, Dodger? Just as long as he stays off the sofa.
Repeat after me.
I, Annette Marie Briers.
I, Annette Marie Briers.
Take thee, Mark David.
Take thee, Mark David.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For as long as you both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Hello, Mrs. Fletcher.
Aww.
They look so happy, don't they?
Yeah.
Okay, ladies, bouquet time!
Go on, then. Go on!
Daft superstition.
Go on!
No, Jeff.
Seems to think she may have solved your house hunting problem.
You have the details?
I can get them for you if you're interested.
I'm always interested.
Dr. Sweet.
Hello, darling.
Dad?
This isn't over, Anna. We need to talk properly.
There's nothing left to say.
If you won't, I'll come back. And I'll keep coming back.
They're calling them the Daffodil Desperados. Nice. But we like Rosemary and Thyme tomorrow night at 9. Next tonight, ITV News at 10.